You look like Ivan Drago, but I feel you look like your whole life.
Yeah, that's what everyone calls
me. Johan Linda is a boxing star from Australia. He looks like Ivan Drago. We're here at the Olympics. So Johan, how are the Olympics going for you?
Yeah, not so well. I lost against the Chinaman Zili Zhang in the first round, so it's a bit disappointing. But look, it's my first Olympics. I've only been fighting for Australia since March, so I'm relatively new to the international scene, and I'll take it as an experience on board, I guess.
That's huge to make the team from March to being here in London. Tell me about that.
Yeah, basically I was focused on winning the Australian title this year in February, and I put all my energy into that for 12 months preceding that. And then everything on top of that was kind of like a bonus, really, like the cream on the cake. And not that I didn't want it, I wanted it really bad, but when you're fighting against guys, the guy I lost to won a silver medal in Beijing, so I'm not too upset about it now, but obviously I was devastated at the time because I'm here for one reason, to win medals, so yeah.
Absolutely. So first of all, why did you choose the sport of boxing? Where in Australia you could have been a rugby player, big enough to play basketball, to field hockey. Boxing is a very tough sport. You have to live it.
Yeah. And I do. I love it. I played Aussie rules football. I was always, being recruited for that to be the ruckman, and I was even earning a bit of cash playing that.
Mundine, he went through
that. Yeah, there's a lot of money in that in Australia, but you got to love what you do. And although I love sport and playing different things, I love boxing. I love the individual sports. I love playing tennis as well, which I'm not too good at it, but for some reason I'm drawn to those sports where it's all down to you, because it's your mental toughness that always seems to be the difference. Whereas in team sports, it's you can hide behind your team, and it's a different ball game when it's just you out there in the spotlight, and I love the challenge of that.
But it's very hard to make money as an amateur boxer. Would you want to turn pro, or do you want to come back for 2016 in Rio?
To be honest with you, there's something about fighting for your country that I love. Turning pro is something that's not really on my mind at the moment. I know I've still, like I said, I'm relatively new to the international scene. I think I've got a bit more experience to gain. Me personally, I'm aiming for the World Championships next year, and look, anything further than that seems a little bit too far away. Commonwealth Games perhaps, sure, Rio, I'd love that, but realistically, you can only aim so far ahead. You don't know what's going to happen in the future, so I'll be doing my best.
What city are you from?
I'm from Adelaide, South Australia.
Is it the biggest city in Australia?
No, it's about the fourth or fifth biggest. It used to be called a country town compared to the other cities like Sydney and Melbourne. Not so much anymore nowadays, but it's I like it. I think it's a great city.
I'm from America, so many times you think about Australia, you think about the kangaroos, you think about the crocodiles.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen any of those in person, or is that just on TV?
Yeah, I got a kangaroo for a pet, and I'm bullshitting.
You got it? Oh, okay.
That's what you guys think, don't you?
No, because I know that if a kangaroo chases you, do you know how you're supposed to run?
No.
In zigzag. Because
really?
Because they can only go in one direction.
See, only an American would know that. Because we don't see them. They're not around. They don't jump around the streets or anything.
They're good at boxing.
But yeah, apparently they're very strong. If they kick you or punch you, you're in a bit of trouble. So.
What's your nickname in Australia as a fighter?
My friends and everyone call me Burger. That's got a bit of a history to it. But everyone calls me Drago.
Ivan Drago. Can you impersonate him? Can you give me a line from Rocky?
If he dies, he dies.
It's cool, but it's very good to see you smiling, because it's one of those things that every athlete comes here with a dream.
Yeah.
And it's very hard to adjust, but you're doing a great job, and maybe it's your competitive nature that you just want to get back in there and do your thing again.
Oh, look, after the event, I fought on Wednesday night on the 1st of August, and I was in tears afterwards. I was devastated, and the next morning I woke up, I didn't want to show my face. I didn't want to do anything except curl up into a little ball. But I've had so much support from back home, and the guys here as well, and the team and other people. My fiance's here as well. And it just makes me realise that there's more to life than sport. There's I've got to enjoy the moment and try and soak it up. And at the end of the day, if I didn't feel disappointed and want to kind of curl up and disappear, it probably means that it didn't mean that much to me. So it means a lot to me. But I'll be back.
Luke Jackson is the captain. What can you tell us about Luke?
Oh, great guy. He's probably the guy. When I came onto the national team in end of February after I won the national title, he's the guy that I clicked with the best. And we've kind of got a bit of a coffee club that we, me, him, and another guy, Jeff Horn, catch up every morning and have a chat. And really good guy. And he's he's probably, to me, the epitome of amateur boxing. He doesn't want to turn pro. He's retiring after this. He just wants to fight for his country at the highest level. And I'm just so glad that he made it to the Olympics, because this is his first and now only Olympics that he would have fought at. I personally, if I made the team and he didn't, I would have given him my spot if I could have. That's how much I can see that it means to the guy. And all I know is in 4 years' time, hopefully, if I qualify and I make it to Rio, I see myself modelling myself on him, because I would have spent 4 years trying to get there. That's what he's done, and the absolute legend of a guy.
There you have it. Perfect. Thank you so much. Anything else you want to add about the experience, about the Olympics? I know Australians, they're very rough in the media in Australia, because you guys, silver's not good enough, bronze not good enough, and they're very aggressive. Is that the nature? Like, everybody just wanted the gold? Or?
Oh, look, yeah. I mean, Aussies, yeah, I think Aussies are like rough diamonds. We're a bit rough around the edges, but if you drill down deep enough, they're all really nice, genuine people. And look, you know, yeah, it's been a great experience. The village has been great, and hopefully I can just enjoy most of my time here.
There you have it. Hopefully we can get you to do a face-off with Klitschko.
Yeah, man, that's what I want.
So there you have it. Look out for Johan. He's doing big things. Hopefully he comes back 2016. For ESDudeReporting.com, I'm Ali Sekbak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter @Sekbak. Are you on Twitter?
Yeah, no.
No Twitter?
Facebook.
Well, what's the Facebook?
Facebook. JT Lind.
JT Lind. There you go.